Hello everybody, this is Els, Elizabeth Craft Designs, as a guest at Scrapbook Centrale. Hello everybody. So I am going to wait for a minute to see if people are coming in. Hello Natalie, how are you over there? You might know that I am in Alberta at the moment. Hi Diane. And no, I'm in Alberta. Sorry, in Kenmore. Bonjour, Dominique. And I'm quarantining, so I am having lots of craft fun. And Natalie asked me if I wanted to do like some glitter techniques. And boy, do I have a lot of glitter techniques. hi, sister. Hi, everybody. And so what I'm going to do, I'm going to play with glitter. I'm not going to make real cards because I want to show as much techniques as possible. And Natalie has the glitter, the Elizabeth Graff Designs Silk Microfine Glitter in stock. And you get 10% discount on the glitter. And the small jars are $8.95 and the large one is $13.25. And the large is only in the diamond, so warm and cool diamond. And I'm going to show you in this live that that might be an option because I use that warm diamond and the cool diamond a lot. So and I love to play with glitter, so that is not a bad thing to do for me because I really like it. So so quarantining in Alberta, and I think we're almost out, but now they're locking Alberta down again, so but you know, we go with the flow, whatever works. So 10% discount, $8.95 for the small one and $13.25 for the large one. And oh, you get loyalty points as well. And I always say when I'm here, je ne parle pas français. That's still the same. So if anybody has a question in French, I know Natalie will answer, or anybody else that is here that will speak French, so they can answer your question. Oh, your second name is Miss Glitter, Rubis. That's nice. That's a good name to have. Yeah, so the glitter, our silk microfine glitter, it's a super fine glitter. The reason, there's one project that I actually have with me that has glitter, that is this one, because that's the reason why we are here and quarantining, because our granddaughter is turning 6 on the 17th. So we said we're going to quarantine for 2 weeks to be at the birthday. But now we need to spread that all out because it's only 5 persons, I think, allowed. But we will make it the most special birthday ever. Only with a few people. We just celebrate a few days with a few people. So first of all, what you need. So I have my box is a cardboard box that I use. If you're working with the glitter, you want to use cardboard or you want to use wood, but don't use a metal tray. And this one is very old because I travel with this box. You might have seen it already. So that is a floor swiffer. So that I have in here in the lid. And then I actually decorated my lid with shimmer sheets years ago now. So that is my box. And then, so it's actually two lids that I'm carrying. So that's my glitter tray. And then when I travel, this goes like this. And I put elastic bands around it. And I have my glitter tray. So that works so well for me. So, and again, I use it for a long time already. My dog glows when I do glitter on card. I know, Diane. Then you go outside and you have to shake it off and then it's all fine again. And you see Diane Prince here, and I will show her beautiful stamps from her and Sonia at the end. And I know Natalie had those in, I think, already. But yeah, it's a beautiful carrying case. Thank you, Cindy. I actually glued it together a little bit more today because I saw some shimmer sheets loosen up, but it needs to stay in one piece because it's just very easy. Okay, so what are we going to do? And I actually had something here that I don't know if I can take it off. That is my start with the diet. Let me see if I can take it off. And if the table is, I'm going to ruin it. I had something with a sticker here, with a peel-off sticker. If my table is shaking a little bit, it is because in our little apartment here, our real table didn't come yet. So I have a plastic folding table here, and I need to burnish or polish the glitter. So if you see a little bit of shaking, sorry about that, but that's because that's the table I have. It is not the perfect stable one. Okay, so of course we start with our tape on cardstock. So those are the pieces I have here to work with. So we have our clear double-sided adhesive. I think Natalie has other tape maybe in stock that will work as well. So there's different sizes. You know, we have the 4-inch, we have the 6-inch. So there's all different sizes, and there's the smaller rolls. What I did right now is I took white cardstock and I put the tape on there and then cut it in pieces. And how I apply my tape is basically you take the roll, I stretch it like this, put it on your cardstock, turn it around, and then cut it off. So that is super easy to do. There's also sheets. I think Natalie has the 6x6 and maybe a few of these in stock, which is also for certain techniques that is nice. And because then you can cut a die straight out of the tape. And I don't know if you saw that, but earlier, like around Christmas time, I did some votive holders. And if you want to do votive holders, then you want to die cut straight out of the tape. And then I can wrap around it on like a votive holder. And there is, if you go to the Elizabeth Kruijzaan's YouTube channel, there is a YouTube about how to do that. But there's also different techniques. But right now, we're going to start. Hi, Erin and Celine, Nancy. Hi, everybody. So, white cardstock with tape on top. So, let me start with how this all started and which I've shown when I do shows, or I've shown it so many times, and it always has a wow factor. It always has a wow factor. I find it on my partner who doesn't even go in my craft space. How does this happen? Aaron, I think he glitters at night. I think he sneaks into your craft room when you're sleeping, and then works with glitter. Yeah. So I take this off. Oh, I see I have a little spot there on my paper. But so I take off the release sheet. You never throw out the release sheet, because that release sheet you're using to cut stencils. So never throw out any release sheet. Also not with the tape, the brown side, because you can use that as well. With Christmas night, can you imagine the card? Oh, it's, you know, it's so beautiful. It's so beautiful. You see, so I can run this paper through, and then you have a stencil, and I can use that stencil, but I get to that as well. But you save all your release sheets. Then this is the most easiest technique with a beautiful result. It's lace. And that lace, if you use lace, don't use lace that has too much cotton in it, because then the fibers from the lace might stick to your tape. So this kind of is a synthetic one. And I'm pretty sure you can find lace anywhere in Quebec as well. And I can use this over and over and over. You even see some black there already. That's from glitter. I can use it depending on the lace. I can use that like 100 times. It doesn't matter. When I did shows, I can use this like the whole day and it would still work. So then you take your release sheet and you, she has pieces of lace, that would be great. And you press this down, because with anything you do, you need to make sure that either your release sheet or the images you use or the lace is pressed down well. Because if it's not pressed down well, you can imagine the glitter that I sprinkle will go underneath the lace, and then you will not have the fine pattern. So always press it down well. Then what you see as well, if possible, I leave a piece of cardstock on the side, and I can trim that later, because then it's easier to pull off the lace or your stencil that you put on. But especially with the lace, if you have a piece of cardstock to pull, and then you can easily remove that lace. So, and I'm going to use the black with the lace, because when you do like a technique like this, because it's a very fine pattern, you want to make sure that you have a good contrasting colors. So don't use like a light green with a darker green together. And that can be really pretty, but then it's more like a subtle background. And maybe I can show you that in a second. You know, I have enough time. So, but if you use nice contrasting colors, you get the nicest pattern. So you see, I sprinkle this. Then I tap it off and I try to stay over my coffee filter. I just brush it off on the side here a little bit. And then I'm going to polish this or burnish this. So you rub that glitter into your tape. So the black will always be the first color you use. And I don't want any contamination in my black or in my diamonds. Because with all the other colors, it will not show that. It will not show. But if you have contamination in your black or you have contamination in your diamond, it will absolutely show up. So a blue and green, if you have a few specks in there, it doesn't matter. It, with all the other colors, it doesn't matter. But with the black, because it's such a strong color, and with the diamond, because it's just, you know, transparent, you will see the contamination. So now I'm going to polish, and I'm going to polish like not as hard. Well, I'm polishing hard, but I try to keep my table still a bit. So I'm not doing like normally I do this, but I don't want to do that now because then my table will shake too much. So like this, then I brush off here where the piece of cardstock is. And I'm going to brush off mostly over my Swiffer, but normally I do it always over a trash can, or actually here, what I have here, I have a cardboard box next to me because I have a plastic trash can and I don't want to do it in the plastic. Because when you use glitter in plastic, it kind of explodes to the sides. And, you know, it's stuck to your trash can. So this is cardboard. I have a cardboard box. I use that as a trash can. And that just works perfect because then it just drops to the bottom. So now I do this. So now I'm going to pull my lace. You see, and now everything everywhere where that lace was is still white, so that white is still sticky. So let me pull that up. You see, so anywhere where it's white, that is still sticky. So of course now I can do a transparent one, so then you basically have black and white, but I'm going to choose a color. But you want to use a like a contrasting color, and one of my favorites that I use a lot is the antique silver. That is one of my, you know, I have a lot of favorites. But antique silver is with the black. I always like that a lot. I actually had a canvas that I carried around. I still have it that I carried around a lot. So you tap this off. Then I'm going to brush this off. You see, and now you see already. And then you're going to polish. So when I brush this off, what's going to happen now? A few specks of the black will absolutely go in here, but it doesn't matter. The only color that I brush off really always over a trash can will be the diamonds. But you want to make sure that you have like a clean workspace. That's with the glitter. Basically, yeah, the detail is incroyable. I know what that means. It is amazing. So you brushed it off and now you're going to polish that. I see some silver on the side. I actually always check the back as well. So brush it off and let me clean this again because that's important. So I tap off that coffee filter over my trash can. And now I'm going to polish this and I will do half of it. And then I don't know, there's another color that you see it better, but, and I always actually say a circular motion, but I try to kind of polish. So I will bring this up and then you can already see the difference between, I hope you can see that, the difference between the polished side or the burnished side and the not burnished side. You see, so that is, there is a big difference. And I always say circular motion because then you get the nicest and even, you see. And now, and so this can be a card front. So you can do a full card font. You can do a check. If you do this, this is actually a nice size to use on a card as a banner. But look at the detail that you see just with a piece of lace. Isn't that gorgeous? It is just, the glitter is absolutely gorgeous. So that is the first one. Then we're going up to the next one. There is so many things you can do. You know what I want to show you? I want to show you when you do colors that are not that contrasting. Then you can see that it will still be really nice for a background. For instance, if you make florals or the flowers and you put those on a background that is less strong, because this doesn't need anything more for me. You can add a word or a saying, but it doesn't need anything more because this is beautiful as it is. But if you say, I want to use it as a background, so not that strong, I show you as well. So I take another piece of the same piece of lace, but just another part of the design, so it will look a little bit different. Thank you, Antonio. Thank you, Deidre. Yeah, it is. It's really, really, you know, the glitter never gets old, because I have done this 1,000 times at least, and I still love it, because you always get a beautiful result. Always get a beautiful result. Okay, so let's pick two colors that are not that contrasting. Let me see. I want a little bit of contrast. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to do red and the saffron. And then you will see. So I do the darkest color first. So you always try to start with the darkest color. But if your colors are close, so in this case, the colors are close together, it doesn't matter that much. So I could have started with the saffron in this case, because it's not such a strong, you know, there's not a big difference. So again, tap off. So basically the thing is, try to work clean. So always a clean coffee filter. So always tap off your coffee filter. And my hands are super dry at the moment. I do some cream on my hands before I start. And I thought, oh no, not. Because, so dry is not good, and a lot of cream on your hands is not good. But for the glitter, you see, so again, I rub this in, and I could have brushed it off a bit more, but I also know that I'm brushing in that glitter easily. You see, so just, I see my table wobbling, but I see on the screen it doesn't. Do I have a favorite color of glitter, Els? If you start, always take the black or the dark. We have a dark brown. Do I have that here? No, I don't. This is from a set. That's the copper bronze, but there is a really dark brown as well. And that is really nice. So you want to have contrasting colors. But I love my black, especially when I do the lace. So then I use the black a lot. Diamond for sure. And with the diamonds, I would recommend like a larger jar. Because the diamond you can also use over... Over a picture, if you have a contrasting picture. If you have scrapbook paper that you want to use as a card front, you can cover the whole part and then do the diamond glitter. I might have something here. Let me see, but I will try to show it as well. So again, take this off. But so the most important thing is, so you see exactly the same detail here, just a different pattern. And now I'm going to tap this off again. So tapping off, make sure your coffee filter is clean. That is important. And now you will see, so you still see that pattern really nicely. So this color is close. And that's actually, saffron is you see it, it's almost gone, but saffron is also a gorgeous, gorgeous color. And now you will see the difference. So you will still see the pattern, but with this one you can imagine, and actually the saffron is one of the ones that really changes when you polish it or when you burnish it. But keeping your space clean, I always have a Swiffer at hand. So, but when I'm done here, when this live is over, I take a Swiffer, I go over the table, and my glitter will stick to my Swiffer, and then it's clean again. And that's what I love. And that is really because of the quality of the glitter. It is so fine. So the saffron is a really, really nice. You know, there's not a color that's... And everybody has his preferences. Somehow I am... with the glitter, I'm not a purple person. I love purple, but I don't use a lot of purple in the when I do this. But that's personal, of course. So now watch this. So I'm going to polish this. I'm going to do this side. And again, I will bring it up. And then you can see the difference again between polishing and... You see that's polished already, burnished, and this is not. But I can still, and I don't know if the camera sees it. Oh, yeah, you can still see the pattern well. And I will keep them both up. And then you can see what I mean, that if you don't have contrasting colors, that there is a difference. But this will still make a gorgeous background, of course. That's Natalie's color. Is that the saffron? Here. You see, so here you see that both the pieces, so you can clearly see with the one I did first, the black with the antique silver, you see the pattern better than with the red and the saffron, but you can still see it, and I can easily like put flowers on there or something else. So that is, purple is Natalie's color. Oh, sorry, Natalie. I have purple as well. I will use some purple, especially for you then. Yeah, but that's exactly what I mean. It's personal. So, yeah. So now this one, I can just save and I can use it over and over and over again. So that is the lace. Then I will go, put this away, and I will, at the end, I will take a picture and then post it on the page or send it to Natalie and she can post it so you can see what we did here. So then a next one. And again, you save all this because I can cut patterns out of that. So then the next one. You can make stencils. Well, let me start with this one. Because then you see I have a stencil right away as well. So these are the florals that I cut out of cardstock and tape. You see, so those are the florals that you normally make the flowers with. And then I cut it out of the tape and the cardstock. So you just put the tape on the cardstock and then you die cut it. Don't use cardstock that is super heavy. You don't want to do that. There's actually a hole in this one. And also right now I cut it out of white cardstock. If I knew for sure when I start that this would be... Oh, it's the Scrapbook Central color. Oh, I should have known that probably. Or the purple wall. Is the classroom purple? Do I remember that? Do we have a purple back, like a craft room in the back? Classroom. Yeah. So if I would have known that this flower would be purple, for instance, I'm trying to make up here. No, if it would be purple, I would do purple cardstock. Because if I choose a color now, you will see the white edge. But since I know, I didn't know which color I was going to use, I just cut it out of white cardstock. So what I'm doing, I'm going to lift up that release sheet. I'm going to lift up a few here and going to lift this up. And don't try to touch the sticky. But now I'm going to lift this up, but I want to keep that release sheet in one piece because now this is a stencil. So you see, we do have, yeah, a purple craft room. That's, I know that now. Yeah, so you see, so now this is sticky. So I'm going to glitter this one, and I promise purple. So I'm going to a purple flower. Here we go. Oh, I apparently use a lot of purple. Or somebody else did, because my purple is gone. Do we have enough to color one flower? Let's see. There is no purple in my jar anymore. Sometimes other people do that. Maybe it's Joop's color because Joop sometimes does the demos as well. Just trying to scoop up the last piece of my purple. Here we go. The last little bit. Okay, there we go. Just put it in there. That should be enough. Okay, so that's now. And I'm going to... So we need a new purple. Okay. So now I'm going to polish this one. And then I'm going to show you one. So you can imagine, you can here. And this one, basically you want to kind of rub away from the edge. So don't do this, because I just going to kind of do this, you see. It is Joep's color, probably. It's not. Oh, he says not. It's not, Natalie. He's in the bedroom next door here. Purple is not your color, Joep.
It's not my color.
Oh, it's not Joep's color. But my purple is gone from my sample set. So, you see, so now I have a floral here. And then, of course, when you do different ones. What is your color? So, you see here, you see I have white edges now. So, again, if you would, oh, teal is Joep's color. Yeah, turquoise teal. That is actually, I love that combination, by the way. And that's why I might have used it. Because I love purple and teal together, actually. So maybe I was lying to you that I said I don't like purple. So polish this one. Then I have my, where do I have it? I have too much around me. I thought I had my tool here. I do. And my ball stylus. So, and there will be some glitter on my mats, but that's fine because I can wash it. But I can take my ball stylus and then shape it. So you can do different layers, of course. So, because I know a lot of you have the florals as well. So you just do this. And then, of course, you can do the different layer, because this one comes with like four different shapes or something. So then you see, like that. You shape it a bit. And then I actually have a center here as well. And that way you can make beautiful flowers in glitter. But I'm going to also show you that we can do, we can color on our glitter. So we can also take a diamond glitter and then color. I just want to finish this floral because I think a flower needs a center. So I'm just going to do that quickly. I have three small ones here. And then I'm going to glue it together. But again, this floral has like four different layers. So you can do them in different tones of purple with a lavender in it. Or, yeah, the flowers are gorgeous. And now we have those beautiful floral stamps. So you see, so if you do this, you see, then you have a nice, but again, normally it has layers. But you can make beautiful flowers in glitter. So that's this. So now I color them in one color. Again, take purple cardstock when you know you're going to make your floral in purple. But what you also can do, so again, that's now a stencil. So we start with the same. So again, we have a white cardstock with tape. Oh, when you get older, you do things you don't do when you're younger. That's true, because I think, oh, you know, I'm actually just turned 60, so, you know, I'm at an age that I think, just go for it, you know, life is too short to kind of think about things too much. Okay, so that now is that one. I'm going to save this again. Now I'm going to take my diamonds, and this one I could probably just dip in there, but sprinkle that, and then I'll show you that you can color on the glitter. And again, I have a lot of these techniques. I know I made a card once with florals with a diamond and color that. But if you go to the YouTube channel, you will find a lot of these techniques. And then I do one technique in like on a card. But in this case, I want to show the different techniques. I know, Nancy, isn't that true? I'll tell you, when I turned 40, so about 20 years ago, I was a sales rep in Europe for Sakura, for the brand Sakura. And I always wear like a nice pants and a jacket or whatever. And then I thought, I just don't like that. My customers know me. I know my customers. And I'm not going to wear anything anymore that I don't like to wear. That was my 40 decision. And I still was the same rep. So still looked clean and nice, but not my... one more cool diamond. That doesn't matter. That doesn't matter in this case. If it makes a lot of difference when I do it on colored cardstock. I will Give me a second. I'm going to get a piece of black cardstock. Quickly. Because the difference between warm and cool is only when you use it on colored cardstock. And I will show you that in a second on a piece of black cardstock. Then I can show you the difference. If it's for this, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. But when you're going to put it over cardstock or over a picture, like colored cardstock, then it's the difference. You see, so now I have my diamonds floral here. And then, let me see, I don't know which colors are because I need to try them. Wait, if they're not dry, because there's Josette's. Yeah, so I'm going to actually put it on here because otherwise, you see, and then you can color on your diamond glitter. And then you can use your blender and kind of blend it out. You need to be quick because this is alcohol based, of course. So when you are taking too long, then the kind of the tape underneath there will dissolve because it's alcohol. I don't know how to explain it better, but that's how it works. Then you can still go back into the glitter, but you see I can brush this out like that. So with your, you see, so you can do that. You can also take a color, of course, and use that as a second color, or you can just, you see, but then you can do some shading on there, you see? So you can do that, but you can also take, I don't know if this one is working well, but yeah, watercolor and glitter. Yeah, but it needs to dry, yeah? Diane, it works, but it needs to dry because, yeah, you see, you can also take a lighter color and kind of go back into that darker color. But again, don't work it too long because otherwise you might pick up the glitter. It will not ruin your tip at all because I teach this technique a ton of times. I did it with a peel of stickers. I wanted to try, but it's coming. So I colored a lot on the diamond glitter. So that works really well. So if by any chance, if you say, okay, I'm working it too long, you can dip it back into the glitter and polish it again because it will still be sticky. But that's a great technique as well. Yeah, Diane, I know Joseph did it as well. With your Tombow markers, Diane, did you use your Tombows? I don't know exactly, but I think you did it with Tombows, and I have those as well. So that could be a different technique for sure. Okay, so now I have a colored flower. I have one with the diamonds. Oh, now I'm going to show you that black first. Otherwise, I totally will forget that again. So let's take a strip, just a strip. So this is black cardstock. Can we stamp on glitters? Yeah, you can. Absolutely. I actually, I had a really nice card with it, but I didn't know how I did it anymore. And you can absolutely stamp on the glitter. But, I know what I did again. Because, let me show you my mistake as well. Because I wanted to show it, and then I thought that, but now I know again. I had a silver piece of glitter, and then I stamped on it with black. And then heat embossed it, and that looked great. But I thought I did diamonds, so that's what I tried. I didn't even heat emboss it, because this is actually stamped on the glitter. So you can absolutely do it when you don't heat emboss, by the way, of course, then. But when I do embossing powder, of course, that goes all in my diamond, and I cannot brush it off anymore. So this was not going to work. But I know now again what I did. If you use silver and then the black embossing powder, that black didn't show up in the glitter. You don't see it. But this didn't work. But if you stamp with black, you know, maybe I can do that in a second as well. Just with your... that should work. Let's do this first. Uh-oh, stuck. So I'm going to trim this. So for the warm and the cool diamonds, for instance, if you use the warm diamonds on a yellow cardstock, because sometimes I get the question and people say, oh, you know, you don't have a baby blue or a baby pink. That's true. Apparently that is hard to make in glitter. Yeah, you can also stamp under the glitter and have a frosted look. Yeah, absolutely. You can do that. Yeah, you can do that. So, but if you use the warm diamond on a yellow cardstock, you have kind of a baby yellow. And that's also how you can, if you do the cool on a light blue, you have a, like you have a baby blue. Okay, so let's do the warm first, but if you can see the difference, you will see how much difference there is. So the warm diamond has more a gold tone to it. So if I sprinkle this, see, make sure my brush is clean. Here, and then I'm going to polish that. And here. And you see it already. It's really, really, it looks like gold. So that's the same that I just showed you in that white flower. You see the difference? So this is the same. That's the same color. So that's, or if, I don't know, did I use warm? I think I used warm for the, yeah, I used warm. I see the gold in there. You see, that's the same color on white and on black. So there is a lot of difference. But then, if I do the cool on this side, let's see, cool diamonds. You see it already when I do this, but then when I polish it, you will see there's a lot of difference. So in white, it doesn't matter, but when you use it on a colored background, for instance, I know I covered a picture like of pine trees, and I use the cool diamond on that one. And that's a gorgeous background. That's a gorgeous background. Here, you see? You see the difference? There's a ton of difference in there. But again, on white, it doesn't matter, you see? So this is the cool, and that's the warm. So that's the difference when you see it on black. Oh, there is a big difference, Diane. There is a big difference. But it's not when you see it in the jar, and it's not when you use it on white, but when you use it on colored cardstock, there is a big difference. There's a big difference. So that is that. Then, you know, let me try that stamping on the, with it. Then I need to use the archival, oh, I have my stamp platform here, so, but I still have the other ink on there, but it should be fine. So I'm going to make this into a diamond, and I think I can also stamp on my tape if I'm correct, but I did, you know, I didn't do that yet, but that probably works as well. But again, your diamonds, if you're new to this, you absolutely want your diamond glitter. And there we go. Put this back. And a coffee filter. So, of course, those coffee filters cost you nothing. When you see that... So I tap it off, and you see there's no glitter on there. But the grease from your hands, at one point, you will see that the filter will hold glitter. Kind of, it doesn't take off that much. So if when you do this, it doesn't come off that well anymore. That's the time when you want to get a new coffee filter. Because at that time, it just doesn't work. You know, the grease from your, kind of from your fingers will leave a mark. So... that's when you want to make sure that you don't... I had a good question for the difference. Rubis, I missed it. Can you ask it again, Rubis? I don't... Oh, for the difference. You mean you asked if I was... What's the difference between warm and cool? Was that you, Rubis? That could be. Sorry. So polish it in really well. I'm going to brush it off. Well, I can do it here. That's fine. Okay, now I'm going to, and I honestly don't know how this is going to look because I still have, I should have cleaned my stamp because I still have the Versamark on there. So I'm going to try. We can only try, correct? Let's see. A little bit there. Oh, sorry. Leaning in. I don't even know if this one fits on here. But it doesn't matter. You get the idea if it doesn't fit completely. So this is actually one of the stamps from Diane Prince that you see here. Yep. Let's see if this works. And if maybe it doesn't stamp completely, but so Diane is here. She's from Quebec, and Diane and Sonia created some gorgeous stamps for us. And this is one of them. So again, my there is still VersaMark on my stamp. So I'm just going to rub it well and see how this works. But it's been a long time that I did it. There's so many beautiful techniques. Let's see. Oh, that will work beautifully. And so if I, what will happen is, the only thing is, and I might, I don't know if, oh, that's gorgeous. Yeah, the designs are absolutely gorgeous. And I will show you cards at the end with the stamps as well. That is, that came out really pretty. So the only thing is, first of all, I think with this ink, probably my Copic will bleed. So I need to do watercolor on that one. And I do, well, I can just color with the Tombos. I can do that as well instead of watercolor. But you see, that's how nice it is. So let's do that then. I'm going to do the watercoloring on this. So let me put this away. You see, so this was not prepared. And it's still working. So what I will do, so if you want a watercolor on there, you can do it. But I do have my Tombos here. But not... let me see if that works. Now I think I need to do that again. That's why you cannot do everything the whole time, but there's so many beautiful things to do. I'm just going to try if I, because I don't have water at hand, so I'm kind of going to blend this in by using different colors. So you say this dries well, eh, Diane? It's been a while since I've done this, but this is actually really pretty as well. And I don't know. And you also know, by the way, you know, another thing that I did before, I'm just thinking about that one. So this is water-based. This is water-based. By the time when I bring in my alcohol-based marker, this is actually now becoming a permanent ink. So, because I add alcohol to my water-based marker. So this now, it actually works really nicely. So this now will be dry in a second because I added alcohol to my water-based marker. So let me see if the other one is dry as well. So if I do this, you see I have color here. I think if I do this, oh, I still have color, it's still drying. That's still drying, but I think this will dry quick and this will take a little bit longer. Yeah, but so because you make this now into, oh, the watercolors. Yeah, the watercolors are nice. Yeah, yeah. Oh, and I did not pick up, but that was my other question that I had for myself. If I used alcohol ink, if my archival would bleed, but it's actually not. Life of Friday. Diane, this will be my Life of Friday. I love that. Love that. So, also possible. That looks really nice. Okay, next. Next, next, next. Okay, so I use my florals. Now I will... we're almost an hour already. Yeah, that is... what kind of ink on the glitters? I use the archival. What I did here, and it actually worked really nicely. And this is, it's been a, I know I made that card once on the silver glitter with embossing powder, but I actually love this. And then I'm going to trim this out. That will be so pretty. So I used archival ink. That's what I just did. And of course your stamps, if you have some glitter on your stamps, you can wash it off. That's all fine, of course. Okay, so white cardstock and tape on top. So now I'm going to use my stencil, and I'm just going to show you one flower, but you can imagine. So this is the one that came off the release sheet that came off from this one. And you can also die cut separate ones, of course. You can just die cut the release sheet. Now I put this down. I'm taking my release sheet. And again, you get 10% discount on the glitter at Scrapbook Central. The small jars are $8.95, so that comes about $8. And it's a microfine glitter, so it will last you a very, very long time. Okay, so press this down. And always make sure, check if it's pressed down well, because if it's not pressed down well, again, you get like that the glitter is running underneath there. So got that. Then let's do, what did I, oh, turquoise. Let's do turquoise. No, what color do I want? I need to think what I want to do my floral in with. I need to think. Do I have a really light one here? Let's do, wait, I need to think. Of course I can, no, let's do a yellow. Do I have a yellow? I have a gold here. I'm going to do gold. So I'm first going to do, I actually want a turquoise flower. So I'm going to show you, so these are two colors. Basically, I tell you that you need to start with this one. But I think I'm fine. The only thing you don't want to do, you don't want to do diamond here. Because then if I do the turquoise, you will absolutely see that turquoise in my diamonds. But I think with these colors, I will be fine. So you don't need to brush it off too much because you're going to polish it in, so you're fine if it is a little bit on that release sheet. Oh, turquoise and green, sorry, Diane. The iPad is always a little bit behind, so I did not see your remark. So this is the light gold, love that one, of course, a gold. You can go classic for Christmas, of course. I was going to maybe use this one because I like that one as well. It's a sea glass. It's a really light green. Or this one is they're all pretty soft green. It's also a really nice one. Okay, so polish this. So you see when I polish that, basically that glitter that you see on that floral, I'm going to polish that or burnish that into that tape. So do this. Then I'm going to brush this off. And then I'm going to take off that floral. And for that floral, it's the same as with the lace, even more, basically. Because that floral, if I keep this in one piece, I can use it over and over and over again. So you see this floral has a dot there in the center. I should have covered that.
Big mistake,
yeah. But I think we will be fine. You can also die cut a dot and stick it separate, of course. You see, I take this off carefully, so now I'm over half, so now I can just lift this up. You see, I have a little dot there. What my idea was that I forgot to... I could actually have done it before I put the floral down, because I thought I'm going to do a center in a different color. So you see, I wanted to do a center of the floral, and then I should have covered that. Or I could have put this down first and then put my floral down. But it's hard to kind of see because then, you know, I don't know where my center is completely. So I did it the right way, but I should have covered my little dot there as well. Or stayed away from it when I glitter. Because another thing I could have done, if I know that dot was there, I kind of could have gone around and not touched that dot. But you see, I make mistakes as well. So let's see. So I'm doing the turquoise. So I can clearly see now that the turquoise is in that gold. You see that? But I think by brushing it off, you see, I take it out of that gold. You see? And that's why you need to burnish or polish really well, because otherwise that color will stick to that. But there is no turquoise in my gold to see at all. So it actually works well. But again, if that would have been diamonds, you would clearly see color in there. Absolutely. I think my comments are, here we go. So now you polish this and you see the difference. There's so much difference in, look at that. There is so much difference in the polishing or burnishing. But you can imagine if you don't burnish, the other color, the next one, will stick to it. So now I have this. Then I'm going to pick up my center. And again, you save that because I can use, as long as I keep these in one piece, I can use them 1,000 times. It doesn't matter. Make sure that you always check that it's clean on the front and the back before you put it on your tape again. Okay, so now that one, I need a... okay, let me do that light green. No, I need to have a little bit of contrast there. I'm going to do a lavender color there. And that gold. But you see, so you can build layers as well. You can build layers of colors. If you do a swirl, you can swirl from one side to the other. You see, and then you polish this one. You see, so then you have your flower in different colors. You see, and then you can imagine if you have a border on your card and you do the different flowers in different sizes, because that floral die set, if you have that, it comes in different sizes. So you have 1, 2, 3, 4. This one, a small one from this one, that's not so easy to use because it cuts in the tape. So this one, you see, it goes to the center, it's open. So depending on your floral design, but of course your leaves are really pretty. I use this one. I use that here, you see. So this will be nice, and then you can put a flower on that. There are so many different techniques, so many different techniques. So the last one I want to show you is when you die cut, I actually have two different ways. So when you die cut out of the tape sheets, so that's what I did here, you see. So you have that brown background. You have that brown background. Then I have, let's say, because I use a lot of, let me see what I have here. Oh, here, a tea bag, because I love working on tea bags. So that's a used tea bag. I actually stamped one of the stamps on there from Diane as well. Gorgeous. But so this is just a used tea bag. It's use it, empty it, and that's it. So then I can take my image here. And what I will do, I will actually trim it somewhere because I want to show two different techniques on there. So I can easily, of course, kind of follow the pattern here and make it a bit smaller. So here I have a pattern. So now with this one, you need to be careful. I hope I can do it correctly, because you don't want to take up the tape. You only want to take up the release sheet, because otherwise the tape will stick to your finger. So I'm going to pick it up here and just pull this off carefully. So now my tape is actually attached to the white part. This, of course, will make a fantastic stencil, but you need to watch for this one. It has a paper side and it has a shiny side. So the shiny side goes down on your paper if you want to use it as a stencil. If you use your paper side, it will stick and it will never come off. So that's one thing you need to watch when you do this. So now I'm going to put this down carefully, and I might go over a little bit and trim it. Okay, so I'm just going to put this down on my tea bag. And another thing you can do with the tape, you can also combine it with embossing powder, with foil. Foil will work really well in combination with the glitter. So now I'm going to trim this one off. And this will make such a nice background for in your journals or in your planner, or that's just really nice. Oh, you love circles? This, yeah, this is, I love this die set. So that's from the journal one. But then the dropout pieces from this one, you see, those are all the pieces that fell out, are fantastic to use. So those pieces are really nice. So I'm just going to stick those on here as well. And then I might actually, I have some gold foil, so I might show you the difference. You see, so I'm just going to add a few here so you can see that. So I, you know, Natalie, I love circles as well. I love circle stencils. I love, yeah, circle dies. It's, I have to say, I like that as well. Okay, I'm struggling with my last one here. I know it will work, but maybe not today. Why is it? Oh, there we go. Got it, got it, got it. Okay, so let's do three. Oh, and now I probably have red on my tape there, but here. You see, so I'm not going to, but this is super fun to use on a photo folder as well. So I have different ones now here. So let me show you different techniques. So with this one, I will just take off the release sheet. And now again, of course, this can now be a stencil, the same as my flower. So don't throw out anything. Don't throw out anything. You see, and you, oh, and don't break it. But you can see as well, so I take them off all at the same time. But you can imagine if you do one and you want to do all different colors, you can do that as well. So now this is, so my tape is now, I think you can see that my tape is there. So that's now sticky. So this one, I will use the glitter. And then the other one, I will do with foil and glitter. Kind of combine it. So you see, so you can do this. And how gorgeous is that? So if you like mixed media, or use this in your journal, or as a background on a card, it's absolutely beautiful. And then don't forget that I show you the beautiful floral stems at the end. Will it work on rice paper? I absolutely think so, Nancy. Yeah. So this one, and I'm a little bit more careful, but it's because it's more fragile. But look at that. That is just gorgeous. Gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous. So that's that. It's only glitter. Now I'm going to take off. And if you want to use tea bags, you let them dry first. And then you are getting out the tea. So I want to make sure that I keep this in one piece. So take it off carefully. Oh, don't touch the tape, Els. Don't touch the tape. There we go. Oh, I tear it. I see, I tear it. Well, that's fine. I did tear this one. This one, actually, you know, I'm going through the foil, but I can, you see, I teared it, but I should have been more careful, but that's fine. When you have a pattern like this, you kind of need to follow it with your tweezer. And I don't want to touch the tape too much. Kind of follow it with your tweezers so you take it off carefully. But you get the idea. If you wreck it, you can't use it anymore. Okay, so again, you can see that pattern on there. Then you take your foil, you see, and oh, it has some white parts in there. And I'm just touching it lightly because I don't want foil everywhere. So kind of rub it a little bit, but you see that foil is now on some parts of the tape, you see? So that's the foil. And then I'm going to add glitter. And now my idea was to do the gold glitter as well, but I actually want to see it with the diamonds. So the gold I use here is the Solar Gold 638. 638 Solar Gold. So, and now this is, do I stick with the gold or do I, you know, I will stick to the gold. But I think this will be really pretty with the diamond as well, when you do the diamonds in there. So what this will do, it will pick up on the parts where the foil is not. And then you get an absolutely gorgeous, and that's what I like this combination. I always love working with the foil and the glitter. So I'm not brushing it off all the way because I want to make sure. You See, and now I'm going to polish this. And what it will do, it will pick up on the parts where I did not have foil. And I don't know if it shows. I will move it up again so you can see it. But how gorgeous is this? And then add some florals or just a saying or... I'm going to tap it off just a second. But that's just absolutely beautiful. So that's a tea bag. That makes a gorgeous, gorgeous background. And I don't know if you can see it, but I see clearly foil and glitter there. Can you see it? I don't know. It's, oh, my light is not that well. I don't know if you can see it, but so that's that one. That will make a beautiful, and of course, I would not do probably glitter flowers on there, but you can imagine that will be really, really pretty with the glitters. I have another one here. This one I did a watercolor first, and then added a leaf with, this is actually embossing. Wrong information. This is embossing powder that I did. You can actually heat emboss on the tape as well. So that is tape. This is tape, and then with embossing powder. Also gorgeous. Okay, so that is the glitter technique. So you can see there are so many possibilities, but if you want to see more, make sure to check out the YouTube channel, and then because there is so much, there's so much. Okay, so make space for the gorgeous sample. So do this with my Swiffer, push this aside for the beautiful stamps. Drum roll, because those are absolutely gorgeous. The stamps, gold is everywhere in your artwork, yeah. And I have samples here. I'm totally hooked to this one as well, but now I'm going to color on glitter for sure. So let me show you the stamps first. You see, so this is the Blossom one. And these are designed by Diane and Sonia. Sonia is in Quebec as well, correct? I think she is. So this is the Blossom one. So it has the word Blossom in it. So you see every stamp set has a main stamp set or a main design. And then we have all those extra elements, the little petals, you can see that as backgrounds. There's so much possible with the stamps. Absolutely love it. And I have to say, Sonia is a tattoo artist, which I can clearly see in the designs by the little dots that you see everywhere. That's kind of the technique that, she's on the North Shore. Yeah, so that's the Blossom. Then we have the Kindness. Love, love, love that design. So this is the little one that you just saw on the tea bag. That's just a gorgeous design by itself. I know we had a card on the Facebook group from Jackie in the UK, and she used several next to each other and then with a saying. Absolutely beautiful. And I know Natalie, I know she had them in stock. If not, she can order them for you. So that's the Kindness. So main image again, and then the beautiful extras, a loose flower here, the petals, that little branch here, just by itself is gorgeous. This one, beautiful. Then we have, and I'll show you samples after this. This is the Forever. And the Forever, so that's a bird, because Diane said, I love birds, and I would like to have birds. I was a little bit careful with the birds because I didn't know how that would go. It's the bestseller. You love the birds. You love the birds. So that's Forever. So it has the main image here. Again, the two birds. Diane posted a beautiful tag this morning with the birds and the flowers. But then the real flowers, like the other ones, the three-dimensional, and put the birds like on top of a combination of the florals with the leaves.
Composition.
Thank you. I was looking for that word, Joop. Yeah. Yeah. Beautiful. And this one says, be still and the earth will speak to you. That's a Navajo proverb. I love that one. Then we have the Friendship. So the Friendship is a hydrangea. You can see that. And then it has the word Friendship. So you have the main image. And then, I know Diane, but I thought it would be difficult to color, but it's actually not at all. It's not at all difficult. And then a little smaller, and then a smaller one. And then a little loose flowers. So that's the Friendship. Then we have the Hope. which are klaproos. I lose all my words at the end. Klaproos, klaproos. Oh.
Poppy.
Poppy. I lose all my words. So that's the hope one. So you see, you have the main image, which I actually have on it. You see, that's a tag that I made here. I absolutely love, especially in my quarantine time, I can just sit down. Pavo, is that the poppy is Pavo, Diane? That could be. And then here we have the gratitude, gorgeous rose design here, composition. And then you have the different elements here as well. Love it, love it, love it. So let me show you some samples. Because, oh, let me, before I forget this one. So I did this one yesterday because you can use it in your planner, in your TN, in your Sidekick. So I made this one yesterday. So I did that on the new paper. So this is actually the new paper book that we, you know, it's not available yet. In a few weeks, Nathalie, if you're still here and you want me to show the book at the end, I can do that. So let me know if you want me to show it, but we don't know exactly when it's coming yet. So you see that floral here, I did some stenciling, some reinforcement. So this will be beautiful in your planner or your Sidekick or your journal. So this is my little TN that I have here. And I made some designs in here because I just love the color. You see, so here I did some stenciling here. That's also from the new paper pack. And then here you see the rose, and this is an element from the journal set as well. Oh, Nathalie, je veux le nouveau book. You want the new book, Julie? It is absolutely gorgeous, I tell you. You see, and then you see those dots here, and that's what's so cool, because it has the, you know, it's just beautiful. And here I did the poppies. You see, and here I'm just going to kind of color in this one. So that is my TN, and then I have some cards to show you. Here, and like I have a little tag here, you see, so that's the tag with the poppies. Just love that. And this is also on a new paper, and here you see that little piece of a tea bag as well. I just stick that everywhere, just love that. Then here, this is just a little tag here from our tickets. Nathalie, do you want me to show the book, Nathalie? Yes or no yet?
Wake up, Nathalie.
Wake up, Joep says wake
up, Nathalie.
So you see, that's the image I just stamped on the glitter as well. And otherwise, we can do that later as well. That is also, so this is the puzzle piece from the TN collection. You see, I call it that. Here you have a tag with the hydrangea as well, some stenciling. Yeah, look at that. Isn't it beautiful? This is also the new book, by the way. You can just, oh yes, okay, I will do that. I was just going to say you want the book, you want the book, because you do want the book. I'll tell you. I think I have it, no, I have it here. Here. Yeah, if you give them both, I can see which one is. That's also the paper. And the book, I have to say, it will take, I think, about 4 weeks before Nathalie has it, for sure. Here, you see, it's just, but you see, again, make a nice composition or do it plain like this. Is this the one without? Yeah, that's the complete one. But the designs are just, so this is, you see this, and this, all the same image, but totally different. I absolutely love, love, love the tag. Oh, you're ordering tons. I hope we have tons, Nathalie. I think you might need to order extra. Here we go. And that's that bird. That's the bird. And it's not difficult at all. Yeah, you want it. And then these three slim lines, I actually did in my live on Monday. This is the easiest watercoloring I ever did with a great result. That's the word from Sue Smith. But isn't it gorgeous? So that's a composition of the different stamps. And you see, I this was so quick and so easy. So much fun to do. Gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous. So those are the stamps. So last but not least, we're far over an hour here, is the reminiscence, the book. So you can pre-order. You can let Nathalie know that you want it. But we cannot tell you yet when it's here. It's on its way to the US. And then we have to ship it to Nathalie. But oh, the bird is Scrubbock's central favorite as well. Yeah, you know, it's I'm happily surprised. So Diane was right. So this is reminiscence of the book. So the book two, we have one as well. If you want one, you don't have that yet. You want one as well. And there are still a few available in the US. We don't have that in Europe anymore. This book, so it has, let me tell you, so it has 64 sheets, 32 in 120 grams, so thinner ones, and 32 in more cardstock, 250 grams. So we have a lot of people ordering two, one to stroke and one to use. But you can cut out all the elements as well. I have those here as well. Wait, just a second. Because I cut out all the different elements already that you can use. You see, so I have tags and all the little labels that are in here. You see? There is so much, all the little tags here. Just wonderful. Here you go. The livre is the book, eh? The livre is the book. Just, yeah, exactly. So there you have the text. So this is the thinner one. But this is so gorgeous. There is so much going on. So this will be for cards, for your scrapbook, for your journals, of course, for your planner, for your TN. You see, so yeah, I want to stroke. That's what I say, two. two to use, one to stroke. Yeah, no, it is absolutely gorgeous. It's absolutely gorgeous. And if you see, so this is more natural. So what Esther did in this one, she used basically four different colors. So this is more natural. Now we go to the greens. Deux, I know deux as well.
It's 20.
No, that's two, Joop. You see, so now we go to the greens. You see? It is so beautiful. And you can use this one to test your eyes, you see? That's just a really fun one. Look at this, the beautiful florals over there. The tag here. So you can cut these out. So I'm still in the 32 pages from... Now we go to oranges. You have to go. Thank you, Deidre, for being here. Look at the tags here. The lady with the girl with the pearl here. Now we go to the oranges. And then we go to yellow from the greens. Some orange, some yellow. Look at this. So this is from June 9th, 1904. The script here that you see. Isn't it gorgeous? Now we go to the yellows. And then I go to the pinks. Yeah, this is really, really, really nice. It's a gorgeous, gorgeous book. That's the one I used for the page that I just showed you. Yeah, you need to, yeah. It's honestly, it is. I'm using one because I had like a few flown in from the Netherlands to make my samples. And all those little tags I cut out. All those little tags. La dame à la perle. Yes. And now we go to the pink. See? It is absolutely beautiful. Beautiful, beautiful book. So these are all the thin ones. See? And then we go to the last one. And now you see, so here is where the cardstock... Joop says, tear one out. No, Joop, I cannot do
was,
that.
Because there was a question.
There was a question?
Can you tear it out?
Yeah. Yes, easily. But then I need to get my other one because this one I need to keep in one piece. So this is my second one. And then you see, I tear this one out already. So it tears out really, really easy. You see? So really nice and clean. The book is not available, Aaron. It's only for pre-order. And it's going to take probably an... We think now about 4 weeks, but you know with shipping these days, we can not predict anything because sometimes and more than once things go wrong these days, but it is at sea, so it should not take that long, but a few weeks for sure, so it's pre-order. So that is it. I want to thank you all for watching. Thank you, Natalie, for inviting me. And we'll see you again sometime, somewhere. And thank you all for watching. Bye-bye.